to our science online session. I heartily welcome you. Students, last week I have sent you link of fourth lesson, Nutrition in Living Organism. In that lesson, we have studied the meaning of nutrition and its type. Let's do revision of it. First, I would like to explain you again the meaning of nutrition. What does it mean? See, nutrition means the process of taking in and using food which takes place in living organism. It is known as nutrition. Children, you know that for running our body smoothly, we need energy, and this energy we are getting from food. So this taking in food in our body and utilizing it, that is known as nutrition. Nutrition is of two types, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Then the example for autotrophic nutrition is green plant. Now how green plant is autotrophic? Let's see that. The word autotrophic is comprises from two words. Auto means self. Tropic means label or figure. They are preparing their own food material. How they are preparing their own food material? See, here I have one green plant, mango plant. It is green in color. Why the leaves are green in color? Because it contains chlorophyll pigment. By using chlorophyll pigment, atmospheric carbon dioxide, water, and by using sunlight, plants prepare their own food material by the process of photosynthesis. That I have explained you last week. Second topic is heterotrophic. Heterotrophic means those who can't prepare their own food material. They are fully depend on others. They are taking their food either from green plants or from animals. That is heterotrophic nutrition. Now today I am going to explain you nutrition in animals. Let's see that. So students, today I am here to explain you about nutrition in animals. We know that we get energy through food. Whatever we are eating from morning up to night, that is our diet. Okay, through that diet we are getting many nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, minerals, vitamins. Okay, but these materials is not directly mixed with the blood, whatever we are eating. First, this material is converted into soluble form, and this goes through various steps. Which are that steps? That steps are ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. The first step is ingestion. What does it mean? Ingestion means food is taken into the body. Whatever we are eating, we are taking in the body, that is ingestion. Second step is digestion. Digestion means what? In this process, there is a conversion of food into simple soluble form, which mix with the blood. Third step is absorption. In this, there is a transfer of soluble food to the blood. Our fourth step is assimilation. In assimilation, there is utilization of absorbed food by cells and tissues for energy production, and it is also used for growth and repair also. And the last step is egestion. In that, there is a removal of waste material through excretory substance. In all these steps, whatever the excretory product is prepared, which is not useful for the body, actually it is harmful. fuel for the body. So our body expel out through the process of excretory system, and that comes under ejection. There are many types of nutrition in animals. The first one is holozoic mode of nutrition. To understand this concept, let us consider amoeba. Children, see the figure of amoeba. You know that amoeba is unicellular living organism. It is microorganism. Microorganism means which we can't see with our naked eyes. It is microorganism. It is single cell animal. Now amoeba don't have the body part like mouth, teeth or tongue to take food inside the body. Hence, they perform the nutrition in holozoic way. How it's run, let us see through picture. Amoeba does not have organs like hands and mouth. It is a unicellular animal. It can take in food through any part of the surface of its unicellular body. It surrounds the food particle from all sides to take it into the cell. After that, it digests the food with the help of different enzymes. Undigested food is left behind as the amoeba moves further with the help of pseudopodia. Pseudo means not actual. Poda means leg. Pseudopodia means not actual legs. It means that they don't have legs like us. They have pseudopodia, means false leg. With the help of that, they move further. In unicellular animals like amoeba, euglena, paramecium, all the states of nutrition occur within their unicellular body. The next topic is, the next type is saprozoic mode of nutrition. Some unicellular animals are microorganisms. They suck their food. They suck liquid organic material from the body of other living things or from the body of dead and decaying matters. That is known as saprophytic nutrition. For example, houseflies, ants, spiders. It means that they are dependent on others for their food and they take their food from dead animals. The third type of nutrition is parasitic nutrition. In this type of nutrition, plants, they fully depend on other animals, other living things. They suck their food from the body of the host. Host means what? From which they are obtaining their food. That is host. For example, mosquito, bed bug. These animals, they suck blood of human beings. As they are sucking their blood from the outer body parts, they are ectoparasite. Ecto means from outside. But some worms which they are placing in the intestine of human beings, they suck ready-made food material from the body of host. As they are placing inside the body, they are endoparasitic animals. So here student, I have explained you different types of nutrition in animals. In that we studied their type, holozoic mode of nutrition, saprophytic mode of nutrition, parasitic mode of nutrition. I hope that you must have understand this lesson. For better understanding, do watch video carefully and try to solve the homework which is given in the online classes. Thank you for watching my video.